Duca, Nacional y Crisol FM, juntos lo hacemos. La educación es el arma más poderosa que puede usar para cambiar el mundo. Conectado con la Estrella, proyecto educativo de Ser TV, Nacional FM, Crisol FM, Radio Nacional AM y Meduca, juntos lo hacemos. Nacional 101.7, Crisol 106.9 FM, Radio Nacional 840 AM, junto a Ser TV y Meduca, presentan Conéctate con la Estrella. Estamos comprometidos con la formación pedagógica de la niñez panameña.
Hello everybody, today it's another wonderful day to learn English. Teacher Evelyn and me, Teacher Yosira, are in charge of this beautiful job, okay? So thank you for joining this class. Today we got very interesting topics for 10th, 11th and 12th graders. But before we start, we got a special guest. We got psychologist Miss Ira de la Rosa, who's going to give us some important tips today, so pay attention.
Thank you, teacher. Bienvenidos a todos ustedes, mis queridos estudiantes de décimo grado. Hoy les vamos a hablar acerca de aquellas recomendaciones que tus docentes pueden tener en estas clases a distancia. Bien, en estos momentos tus docentes son aquellos que con dedicación y esfuerzo, ¿sí?, establecen esas clases para ti. Afrontan el reto de enseñar ahora virtualmente. Por esa razón, debemos entonces apoyarlos a nuestros docentes. Y es importante pues que pongas atención a estos consejos. Escúchalos, no solo es la clase, sino también cuando expresen algún sentimiento. Importante, presta atención si sus palabras y sus gestos o movimientos, si ellos necesitan ayuda. Muéstrale comprensión si el docente pasa un mal momento en clase. Una palabra de aliento también o afecto ayudará a tu docente en estos momentos cuando te dé tu clase. Bien, dentro de esas recomendaciones que podemos darte, y principalmente para tus docentes, la organización y ver su agenda es importante. Sabemos que en estos momentos, entre lo que es la familia y dar las clases a distancia, es un poco difícil, pero estando un poco más organizados, podemos entonces ampliar un poco más. Realizar sus horarios tomando en cuenta siempre un periodo de descansos, que se tome un tiempo para él, por lo menos unos 10 minutos, eso es importante. Ser flexible, es verdad, sea flexible ante la situación que está pasando también su estudiante y ser empático ante la situación. Busque tiempo para usted mismo y aquellos profesores que son más felices y contentos con su trabajo van a impactar muchísimo mejor en las clases. Bien, por ejemplo, si hay algún profesor o hay alguno que desea hablar, se puede entonces buscar ayuda a un especialista de salud mental. Eso es importante también. El especialista de salud mental lo que hace es ayudarle y darle herramientas si necesita. Bien, tenemos las líneas telefónicas psicoemocionales. Por ejemplo, Chiriquí 774-4428, Coclé 991-1024. En estas líneas psicoemocionales estamos para escucharte y asimismo, pues estas líneas están de lunes a viernes de 8 de la mañana a 3 y 30 de la tarde. También la pueden solicitar a través del WhatsApp de la emisora 60 serante. Vamos con ustedes los de 11. Bien, thank you, teacher.
Thanks to you for your words. Teacher Evelyn, can you tell us people who are joining this class, 10th grade?
That's right, we have greetings, señora de Fátima, estudiantes de los estudiantes de la profesora Mónica. Regards to students premedia multigrado El Ciruelar, la profesora Antonia Herrera, San José de San Francisco, de Boca de Balsa, Humberto Palacio. Hello to them.
Thank you for joining this class. Remember that you can participate, that you can ask questions, you can make comments also, okay? You get the opportunity through Instagram, Facebook, and WhatsApp, okay? The topic for today, nutrition and healthy habits. Very important topic. Remember that this day that we have to stay, it's mandatory that we have to stay at home. So we have to do activities there. And one of the activities that we like to do is to eat. Teacher Evelyn,
that's
you know
right.
that. Yeah,
I like to eat.
So it is important to take in consideration the nutrition and healthy habits that we need to keep when we are at home, okay? The learning objective of the class, to learn and to use vocabulary in context related to nutrition and healthy habits. Also to describe good healthy habits in order to improve quality of life. We got an interesting fact here. Teacher Evelyn, it says, did you know that eggs are one of the healthiest food for you, food you can eat? Let's say again, eggs, huevos, are one of the healthiest food you can eat. Remember, healthy, saludable. Very interesting to know.
Yeah, wow. That's right.
We got a vocabulary also. And this vocabulary, it's about nutrients, okay? Nutrients are substances that produce organic compound that can help our body to keep us healthy, okay? All the nutrients are important, are very important. But we cannot eat them excessively, because if we do it, okay, it can have some problems in the future with our body, with our health, okay? So we're gonna see some of them. Teacher Evelyn is going to help me with the pronunciation, okay? But you have to remember that these nutrientes, you know them in Spanish, but today we're gonna learn the pronunciation and spelling of these words in English, okay? So let's start. A, nutrients.
Nutrients.
B, carbohydrates.
Carbohydrates.
When we talk about carbohydrates, we talk about foods such as cereal, pasta, potatoes also. C, proteins.
Proteins.
Okay, so when we talk about these, we're talking about meat. When we eat meat, we can get proteins, okay? Fat.
Fat.
As I was saying, nutrients are important, okay? All of them, okay? But some people say that when we eat fat, okay, it can be, you know, dangerous for our body. However, it is important too. The point is, do not abuse of eating them. When you eat them, try not to abuse of them, okay? So, fat we can find on food like eggs, cheese. And another one, minerals.
Minerals.
We can find minerals when we eat vegetables and fruit. Also, vitamins.
Vitamins.
Okay, and fruits and vegetables. Grease.
Grease.
Grease, when we prepare or cook food with a lot of oil, aceite, so it generates like a grease food, okay? It is not good for our health, okay, but sometimes it's necessary, okay? We don't have to eat them excessively, as I said before. Cholesterol.
Cholesterol.
When we talk about cholesterol, for example, eggs, these are an example of eating food with cholesterol, okay? Let's continue, and we got, what do you know? There are five nutrients, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals, vitamins. Name the nutrients in each food. So we got two pictures here. We got two pictures here. In picture number one, there is a picture of a great and delicious vegetable salad. And in the second picture, we got delicious French fries and a hamburger. Okay, but you have to tell us, for example, in picture number one, in the salad, vegetable salad, what are the nutrients that you can mention in that picture? Also, in picture number two, when you see French fries and a hamburger, what are the nutrients that we are getting when we eat this, okay? So, remember that you can chat us, you can send your responses through Instagram, and Teacher Evelyn is going to help us with your comments and questions, okay? Let's move on. And we got basic principles for good nutrition. Basic principles for good nutrition. Remember that you got this information in your booklet, page 74. Page 74. Have 4 meals a day. 4 meals. 4 comidas al día. Breakfast, the most important one. Lunch, dinner, and a light snack. When we say a light snack, for example, I don't know, Teacher Evelyn, you can tell me, do you consider a pizza is a light snack?
Yes.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, because if I eat pizza, then after an hour, I will hungry.
Okay.
Again, so I will say.
Okay, but light snack will be like after dinner. We can have pizza, yeah, but also it says light, so that will be like an apple or an orange. Mm. Okay, for a snack, no? But you like pizza, well, that's okay. The next one, eat slowly and chew food very well. So don't eat fast. That is not correct. Do not skip meals schedules, okay? Do not skip meal schedules. If you have breakfast at 7 a.m., so you have to continue having breakfast at 7 a.m. Do not change the schedule. Drink a minimum of 2 liters or 8 glasses of water every day. This is very important. Drink a minimum of 2 liters, 8 glasses of water every day. The next one, eat low fat food. We say that fat food, it's necessary as a nutrient. However, it is not good if we eat fat food like junk food, like McDonald's and Kentucky. We like that, delicious, but it's not good, you know, to have that every week or twice a week or 3 times a week. That is not correct, okay? So we have to avoid that. And also, we have to include fruits and vegetables in our meals. Fruits and vegetables, very important. So these basic principles for good nutrition, you have to take in consideration when you are at home having any of your meals. Let's practice, and we got choose the correct answer. According to this topic, okay, and the principles that I read before, you have to take in consideration 2 answers that you got there, and you have to tell us which one is the correct one. Number one, how many meals are recommended? And we got 2 options, A, 3 meals, or B, 4 meals. Number two, how much water do you have to drink every day? How much water do you have to drink every day? 8 glasses or 2 glasses? And number three, why should you avoid fat food? A, it may affect blood circulation, or B, it's delicious, okay? So let's see, Teacher Evelyn is going to help me with the responses here. Number one, how many meals are recommended? 3 or 4?
4.
Good. That would be B. Number two, how much water do you have to drink every day? 8 glasses or 2?
8 glasses.
8 glasses. Thank you. And number three, why should you avoid fat food?
I'm sorry, teacher. Just see, I have response here. Breakthrough WhatsApp. We have here Celis. He wrote the letter B. I thought it's number 1B. That's right.
Very good.
And for number three, I have Hugo from de la Comarca. He wrote the letter, the A.
A, very good. It may affect blood circulation. Thank you. We were expecting that response, but you did it. Great. Okay, let's continue. And we're going to talk about a little bit about grammar, quantifiers. I'm talking about food. In order to talk about amount, cantidad, okay, we need to use the quantifiers. Some, any, a few, a little, a lot of, okay? So, in order to use them, we need to make sure that we are clear about the about countable and uncountable nouns, okay? Sustantivos contables, sustantivos no contables. For example, the word share, silla, okay? We can say 2 shares, 3 shares. So these are countable nouns. It's a countable noun. Es un adjetivo, un sustantivo contable. But in the case of salt, sal, we cannot say 1 salt, 2 salt. We can say 1 package of salt, but we cannot say 1 salt, 2 salt. So that is a non-count noun. Es un sustantivo no contable. So in this case, we need to take in consideration this in order to use some, any, a few, a little, and a lot of. Some, We can use it with count and non-counts. For example, we bought some flowers. I need somebody to fix my car. Necesito a alguien que me ayude a arreglar el carro. I want something to eat. Necesito algo de comer. Any is used in questions and negative form. En preguntas y en oraciones negativas. Do you have any wine? Is there anyone who can help me here? ¿Hay alguien que pueda ayudarme aquí? I don't have anything to eat. No tengo nada que comer. Okay?
Teacher, you see that I'm going to say some greetings here. Abdiel, Dana Sofía, and Juana. Also, saludos a la profesora Marquela Romero. Que Dios la bendiga.
Hello. Thank you. Yeah, and as I was saying, a few and a little, okay, a few and a little, both means the same, pocos. However, few is used with countable nouns and little with non-count nouns, con los no contables. A lot of, que habla no contable, a lot of shares, a lot of sugar. So, podemos utilizarlo con palabras que son contables o palabras que no son contables. Okay, so we gotta practice here. It says also choose the correct answer. Okay, teacher Evelyn is going to help me with the responses here. You have to choose between one of the two quantifiers we got here. Number one, I have oranges, a little oranges or a few oranges?
A few,
because we're talking about count nouns. Estamos hablando con sustantivos contables. So a few oranges. I don't have meat. Any or some?
Some.
Okay, any. In this case will be any because it's a negative sentence. And number three, there is any or some milk in the fridge.
Some.
There is some activities to win the game. Color the boxes that you pick to show the activities to do. Tienes que escoger tres actividades de las que tienen en la página 78 de su guía para realizar en casa. So, we finished with 10th grade and we are back with 11th grade and teacher Evelyn is going to be in charge of those groups, okay? So, thank you for being here. Don't move, stay there.
Con la visión de fortalecer la participación de los padres de familia y los integrantes de la comunidad educativa, escolar y regional, el Ministerio de Educación, en alianza con las emisoras comprometidos con la formación de todos los estudiantes a nivel nacional, ha creado el proyecto educativo Conéctate con la Estrella.
Hoy vamos a hablar de la comunicación para sexto grado.
Los números naturales son aquellos que nos permiten contar los elementos de un conjunto.
Donde miles de niños y jóvenes se beneficiarán con las clases dictadas por profesores a través de la radio para estudiantes de primaria, premedia y media. Una alternativa educativa para los estudiantes que se encuentran en casa respetando la cuarentena por la pandemia del COVID-19. De esta manera, Meduca y Crisol, Radio Hogar, Radio Católica, La Voz Sin Fronteras y Radio Mi Favorita. Con la visión de fortalecer. Hoy más que nunca necesitamos estar unidos y bien informados.
Este es un equipo y el equipo se llama Panamá.
El futuro de profesores y padres de familia puedan acceder a estos recursos y sigan aprendiendo desde casa como Ayudinga, portal educativo Educa Panamá, clases virtuales, foros educativos, capacitaciones para docentes, módulos didácticos, leemos un cuento y más de 300 cursos virtuales. Estas y otras iniciativas que impacten al país estaremos informando por Ser TV.
Back now for 11th grade, guys, and today we have a special guest. Es la psicóloga Ira de la Rosa.
Yes, teacher, thank you. Sí, ahora vamos con ustedes, mis queridos estudiantes de 11th grado. Vamos a hablarles sobre aquellas recomendaciones para tus docentes o maestros sobre el manejo del estrés, pero aprender de esta tecnología. Ten paciencia, saben un poco más de esta tecnología, pero bueno, también pues pueden necesitar de esa ayuda y les puedes ayudar. Bien. Dentro de esto, tus profesores se pueden adaptar a los nuevos cambios, a los nuevos paradigmas. Ahora tus profesores son aquellos facilitadores que te dan esas clases a distancia. Precisamente estarán utilizando todas estas técnicas y metodologías. Y esto se puede aprender. Está la mentalidad abierta, que también tus profesores deben de tener para las nuevas tecnologías. Ir poco a poco, ir aprendiendo esto poco a poco. También está la enseñanza en línea, que es un proceso que se debe valorar. Tus profesores pueden variar las metodologías, no todos los temas tienen las mismas metodologías. Pero tú como estudiante también eres parte de ese proceso de enseñanza, así que busca información por ti mismo, sea autodidacta. ¿Y qué ser autodidacta? Precisamente es aprender a investigar por ti mismo, a buscar la información por ti mismo, ¿ve? Asimismo, esto, tus profesores te ayudan planificando las clases para fortalecer aquellas habilidades de pensamiento crítico y reflexivo de ti mismo. Igualmente, este proceso de educación en línea debe facilitar la enseñanza de competencias. Mis profesores de alguna manera se sienten instantes también. Tenemos varias líneas de telefónicas psicoemocionales en las varias regiones del país. Tenemos, por ejemplo, Herrera 970-0278, Panamá Oeste 515-7396. Estas líneas están abiertas de lunes a viernes de 8 de la mañana a 3:30 de la tarde. Igualmente, estas líneas las pueden solicitar a través del WhatsApp de cabina al 6004-8182. Así que, bueno, muchas gracias. Y más adelante seguimos con nuestros estudiantes de 12.
Move on here for 11th grade. And the topic for today is our flora and fauna. Okay, remember that our country is a tropical paradise and we can find a huge variety of animals and plants. Learning objective, you are going to learn concepts about this and also that you are going to distinguish elements of our flora and fauna. Okay, and did you know that the Isthmus of Panama forms a land bridge? What is land bridge? Es un puente de tierra, ¿verdad? De extremo a extremo. Between North and South America. Between North America and South America. And that is the reason why we have a lot. We're going to practice vocabulary here, right? Teacher Yosira is going to help me. I'm going to give you some meaning. Okay, remember that you guys need to practice at home. You need to practice vocabulary in order to continue improve English, okay? We're going to explain a little bit. For example, we talk about number one. Yes, teacher Yosira?
Yes, I want to stop this. Gracie 9695, Maylin 05, and also Tatiana de Quinto. Very, very happy to have you here. Estamos muy contentos de tenerlos. Recuerden que pueden participar en la clase.
Hello, that's right. You can send messages through Facebook, WhatsApp, human beings. And we will talk about nature. We talk about everything. When we talk about flora, that it will be number three, the flora, we talk about plants. And fauna is when we talk about animals. Now let's continue with the practice and vocabulary here. We have number five, ecosystem. Ecology.
Ecology.
Biodiversity.
Biodiversity.
Harpy eagle.
Harpy eagle.
Very good, that's right. And when we talk about ecosystem, right, it's because it's the community or group of living organisms and their physical environment. We have example, we have forest, we have the desert, the river, the coral reefs. When we talk about ecology, in the number six that you can see the pictures, ecology is when we talk about animals, it's alive, okay, que están vivos. And the number eight, that you see the picture, is a bird, it's a harpy eagle. This is our national bird. Excellent, guys. Now we have a practice number one here from vocabulary. You are seeing here some words. We have number one, harpy eagle, flora, fauna. Number four, biodiversity. Number five, wildlife. And you need to match with the other side, right? There are some pictures. We have the letter A, B, C, D, and E. Remember that you can send the answers through Facebook, WhatsApp, or through Instagram. And teacher, Yosira is going to help.
Well, I would say it would be D.
That's right, the letter D. Very good. Number two.
Number two, Flora will be E.
That's right. And let's do another one. Vamos a hacer una última. The number three. The fauna will be?
The fauna will be letter B.
Is when it's used to communicate what someone else said, think, or believe. For example, en este caso sería alguien me dijo, ay, mira que fulanito me dijo esto. Bueno, eso, en ese caso se usa a reported speech. And we need to change some words because we are not going to say exactly words. No se dice las palabras exactas, ¿verdad? Se cambia un poco el contraste de estas oraciones o de este contenido. A few changes are necessary. Now, I'm going to give you some examples. We have, when we talk about indirect speech, when we talk about present simple, the indirect speech que va a ser reported speech va a ser en past simple. In present continuous, when we talk about in present continuous indirect speech, then the reported speech will be past continuous. And if in the direct speech we talk about present perfect, then the reported speech will be said in past perfect. Okay, I'm going to give you some examples. It's cold. Cuando alguien dice, it's cold, ahí está siendo en presente, it's cold. But if I want to say it like a reported speech, pero si lo quiero decir como un reported speech, como que alguien me dijo de una forma indirecta, yo lo cambio a pasado. For example, she said it was cold. See the differences? One is in the present, there is direct speech, and the other one is in the past, indirect speech. I'm going to give you another example. I'm teaching English online. I'm teaching English online. I'm teaching is present continuous. Está en present continuous, right? So this is direct speech. But if I want to change it to indirect speech, then I change the tense. Cambio el tiempo to past continuous. So we were saying, she said she was teaching English online. See the differences? One is in the present continuous, de forma directa, ¿ya? And when we are going to change it, cuando lo vamos a cambiar, porque esta persona me dijo algo, ella me dijo, o él me dijo, o ellos me dijeron, lo cambiamos. Todo depende del tiempo en que está, se le habló a la persona. Present continuous, I'm teaching English online. Past continuous, she said, we need to say she said, si fue una mujer, she said, o si lo dijo un hombre, he said. In this case, will be she said, she was, ¿sí? Was teaching, this is past continuous. Was teaching English online. Okay, guys? Okay. Okay, I'm going to give you another example here from time and places. Aquí también se entra cuando es tiempo y lugar. Time and place changes. For example, we have some example. Direct speech, a month ago, today, tonight, this, yesterday, now, and so on. And when it's reported speech, right, it is different. For example, when I say a month ago, it will be before. Today or tonight, then I will say that day, that might. Okay, I'm going to give you examples. A month ago, en el pasado, we had an awful accident. We had an awful accident. Ahí está pasando la acción, o sea, ahí pasó, ¿verdad? Nosotros tuvimos un accidente horrible. We had an awful accident. But if I'm going to say, si una persona me lo dijo, ya, que sería el reported speech, me lo va a decir de esta manera. Okay? She said she had a month before. An awful accident a month ago. Y el report speech va a ser they had, she said, they had had a month before. ¿Vieron que se cambia? Tampoco. These are our dogs. Ellos son nuestros perros. These are our dogs. These are our dogs. Ahí vemos que está en presente, simple present. These are our dogs. Then we need to change it to the past tense. He said or she said, dependiendo quién lo dijo. She said or he said, those were their dogs. Those were, ¿sí? Were is the past. Were, y no decimos our, porque no están hablando de mis perros, sino de la persona que me lo está diciendo. Esos eran sus perros. Their dogs, ¿sí? So it's a little bit complicated, but you need to practice. You need to get to your booklet. Esto está en su guía. On page 74, they are going to explain a little bit about this. So you need to practice a lot. So you need to be not confused. No puedes estar enredado, y para eso tienes que practicar. You have to practice grammar and context. You have to read. You have to follow instructions and make sentences. Okay. Now let's continue with the topic, Raúl, about flora and fauna. Yes, teacher Yacine.
I want to send Shanti here. It says hello, teacher, full toning, Professor Anaís Herrera. Thank you, Professor Anaís, for joining our class, listening to us. Okay, thank you very much.
Yes, let's talk about endangered species, right? Here in Panama, we have four endangered species. Now I'm going to mention, we have the harpy eagle, right? We have the Panamanian golden frog, spider monkey, and sea turtles. There are four animals that are endangered species here in Panama. And remember that when we talk about endangered species, we talk about a group of organisms and life forms that are facing the threat of extinction. Why? Because we are not taking care of our nature. So it's very important to be take care of the lands, the environment, about everything here, okay? Because there are animals that are endangered. That we, I'm going to tell you again, I'm going to say again, the four animals that are endangered here in Panama. We have the harpy eagle, the Panamanian golden frog, spider monkey, and the sea turtles. Okay, guys? Now you have an assignment here. On your booklet also, you're going to find here the assignment that you need to follow some questions. You have to respond. What does a college study? Mention three endangered species in our country and write three sentences using reported speech. Remember that you can find all this information through your booklet, right, on page 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, and so on, okay? So please, guys, it's very important to practice vocabulary and also practice grammar in order to talk more a little bit of our language, beautiful language that is English.
And to remind students our password, remember that we got a Google Classroom with information that you can have access there. JIHRZGW, JIHRZGW, la contraseña.
That's right. So please don't move the lesson for next class. You can have it right through our platforms. And don't move. Next class will be 12th grade, guys. So see you. Don't move.
Bye.
El proyecto del Ministerio de Educación, Conéctate con la Estrella, también está en la radio. De lunes a viernes de 11 de la mañana a 12 mediodía es el turno de los chicos de primaria. Sintoniza Nacional AM y FM y Crisol. Prepárate para aprender y no quedarte sin saber, porque a las 2 de la tarde se vuelven a activar para los de premedia y a las 3 para los de media. Ya lo sabes, si eres de primaria, premedia o media, esto es para ti. Conéctate con la Estrella, un proyecto de Meduca, ahora en la radio, por Nacional AM y FM, Crisol, y por nuestras redes Instagram Live, arroba Nacional FM Panamá, arroba Crisol FM Panamá, Facebook Live, Nacional FM Panamá, Crisol FM Panamá, y Twitter, arroba Nacional FM y Crisol FM.
La
La educación es un proceso que no termina nunca. Siempre hay algo nuevo que aprender. Conectado con la Estrella, proyecto insignia de SER TV, Meduca, Nacional y Crisol FM. Juntos lo hacemos.
Hello guys, we're back here for 12th graders, and today we have a special guest, that is psychologist Ira de la Rosa.
Thank you, teacher. Buenos, mis queridos estudiantes de 12º grado, vamos con ustedes, vamos ahora a hablarles sobre algunos tips que tus profesores o maestros pueden utilizar para estas clases a distancia. Bien, tus profesores pueden poner en práctica los consejos que les vamos a dar y pueden auxiliarse ante las tecnologías. También les puedes ayudar ante esto. Hay que ser empáticos con ellos también. Hay profesores que pueden ser bastante dinámicos con las clases a distancia, pero hay otros también que también tienes que tenerles paciencia. Bien, hay algunos tips como, por ejemplo, se puede buscar en internet. Pueden buscar tus profesores en internet y hacer resúmenes y citas y guardarlos en OneDrive. Igualmente pueden utilizar el PowerPoint. Además de ponerle las figuras, pueden ponerle también los videos, incluírselos ahí. Pueden ser videos de ellos mismos o videos de web. Igualmente puede ser, también para que las clases sean interactivas, pueden ser, pueden abrir calendario y hacer llamadas en Teams. Esto es en la plataforma Teams. E igualmente, para poder evaluarte a ti, pueden entonces utilizar la herramienta Forms. De manera muy creativa, se prepara la evaluación. Tu profesor te la puede enviar a través de tu correo y responder las preguntas, y luego tu profesor te lo puede calificar. Igualmente, hay otras formas. Por ejemplo, también esto, se pueden compartir contenidos en la nube de forma gratuita para hacerlo dinámico, y además pueden asistir a foros compartiendo información con otros profesores también. Tu querido profesor puede seguir su propia automotivación, porque de esa manera se puede dar espacio a la virtualidad. Ya en este caso, si por ejemplo en otro punto tu profesor también necesita pues apoyo, ayuda emocional, en el sentido de que se siente estresado, agotado, quiere hablar con alguien, igualmente puede pedir la ayuda a un especialista de salud mental, que eso también es importante. Están las líneas psicoemocionales en cada una de las regiones del país. Tenemos Coclé 991-1024, Herrera 970-0278, Bocas del Toro 758-5377, eso entre algunas que están de lunes a viernes de 8 a 3 y 30 de la tarde, así que también las pueden pedir en el WhatsApp de cabina, que es el 60048182. Estamos para escucharles y servirles, así que muchas gracias. Ya entonces nos vemos hasta la próxima semana. Chao. Thank you, teacher.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wow. That's right. So for today, for 12th grader, but before beginning, teacher Yasira is going to say some greetings here, right?
Yeah, we got greetings here in Instagram to Maria Fer, Nairobi-P11, Giselle96. She's saying hello, hello, Giselle. Thank you for joining the class. Remember that you can participate. Also, I want to send a special greeting to a person in Instagram. It says he's from Boca La Balsa. His name is Humberto Palacio. He's asking questions about the topic about grammar. Okay, thank you for being here to trust us about these topics. Okay, so thank you very much. Remember that you can send your responses, you can interact with us, send your answers, comments, anything that you want to say, and greetings also.
That's right, very very good, Humberto. Good. Okay, the lesson for today, it's technology platforms and apps and their influences in human life and education during the COVID-19, right? Okay, learning objective, guys, that you will be able to identify the difference between a platform and applications. And also you will be able to talk about the disadvantage and advantages about this the platforms in education. Now, let me ask you something, or let me say something here. Do you know, Pay attention. Do you know over 850 million children and youth, right, had to stay away from schools and universities due to the COVID-19. So, wow, this is a huge, huge amount of students that are away from schools and university, guys. So it's very important that you are having this kind of education here through the application of platforms like Zoom, like Google Meet, because, or from radio and TV like Conectate con las Estrellas, right? Because they are giving you information and their education here right now, okay? Let's review some vocabulary. Teacher Josina is going to help me here to pronounce the words, and also, guys, you need to repeat as well, okay? Hangouts. Google Meet.
WhatsApp.
YouTube.
Instagram.
Telegram.
Stay in touch.
Advantages.
Disadvantages.
Zoom.
Moodle.
MS Teams. Very good. I hope you did it at home, guys. Now, think about this. Tell us, what do you feel or what do you think about advantages and disadvantages of using platforms during this pandemic? And also, what is going on with you guys about the platforms for educational purposes? Okay, give us ideas or your opinion about disadvantages or advantages in education, okay? Give us your opinion or idea about this. I'm going to say something. I want to share my opinion. And I know that there are some disadvantages here, right? But also we have advantages, and I think that even though we have disadvantages, there are more advantages that you can learn about this, about Conectate con las Estrellas, about the platform through Instagram, about teachers that are connecting with you guys through Zoom or through Microsoft or even Google Meet. So it's very important that you need to consider this and practice and improve your English, or even though the other classes, the other subjects, they are very important, guys.
Can I share something, Teacher Evelyn? Also, I can say that the advantage for me will be, you know, the opportunity to improve my knowledge about technology. Okay,
that's right.
And disadvantages, okay, when you got problem with the internet, well, that is a problem that for you to get your to your virtual class. So that will be like a disadvantages. Advantages, because I'm learning about technology. Disadvantages, when we get some problems or when we don't have computers or cell phones at home. That will be a disadvantage.
That's right. Thank you, teacher. Okay, let's talk about the next topic, that is education in times of pandemic. Here in Panama, for example, the Ministry of Education, if you do not know, the Ministry of Education accepted the challenge. The challenge means that un reto, that's right, thank you. Un reto grandísimo, ¿verdad? Porque la escuela fue prácticamente al inicio cerrada. And the Ministry of Education take actions of this, right? And they created two type of classes. We have the synchronous and the asynchronous classes. I'm going to explain a little bit about this. But with these classes also, they prepare teachers using the Microsoft Teams, and also they give a lot of seminars about Google Classroom, the Zoom platforms, and also the Google Meet, right? They give you a lot of seminar, and teachers learn about this. As a teacher, Josita, they have to learn about computers, about technology, and this is an advantage that we have now, even you guys, you the students also. So let me explain a little bit about synchronous and asynchronous classes. When we talk about synchronous classes, it's because we have contact, not contact, but it's like face-to-face with the teachers and the students through online, right? It's virtual in this case. And asynchronous classes, que son asincrónicas, is when the teachers send information, send assignments, and send works without having the face-to-face. In this case, you can have the opportunity to do homeworks or the assignments in a period of time, without a real time, even though the synchronous classes it's in real time. Okay, so knowing this, let's do the practice number one. And I'm going to give you three sentences or three answers, and you need to choose it will be the A or it will be letter B. Okay, this is a practice.
But before we continue, we got two more people here joining the class. Three more. It say Magda 0789, Quintero Marlene also. We got two more people here joining the class. Thank you very much. Remember that you can participate, okay? You can interact with us. You can chat us, okay?
Yes, that's right. And let's do this practice. And you know about this, so pay attention to this. Number one, Google Meet. What is Google Meet? It will be A, an apps, or B, a team. Number two, asynchronous means. What is asynchronous means? Okay, it will be A, face-to-face interactions, or B, not existing or happening at the same time. And number three, a chat is. What is a chat? A, to talk in a friendly way with someone, or the letter B, to exchange messages with somebody on the internet. Okay, what do you think? Okay, number one, I'm going to give you the answers. Number one, Google Meet will be the letter A. It's an apps, okay, application, right? Two, asynchronous means, as I explained before, is asincrónica. Las clases asincrónicas van a ser the letter B. It's not existing or happening at the same time. It's not, so it will be letter B. And number three, a chat is. It will be A? No, it will be the letter B. That's right, letter B, exchange messages. Very good. Let's do a quickly here, practice number two. Remember that you can have access to your booklet, right? The guide, la guía que tienen con ustedes on page 72, 71, 72, 73. In this case, the practice number two will have it on page 72. It will be true or false. Tell us your opinion about this. Number one, Panama has a strategy for education due to pandemic. What do you think? Is true or false? Panama has a strategy for education. Well, I would say that it's true. As I said before, Ministry of Education should take the challenge here. So it's true. Number two, teachers can communicate using WhatsApp with the students. What do you think? Is true or false, Teacher Yoshida?
Well, I would say it's true.
That's right. It's true. Teachers can communicate using WhatsApp. And the last one, the number three, learning remote is not one of the consequences of COVID-19. What do you think? Is true or false? Learning remote is not one of the consequences of the COVID.
I would say false.
That's right, because the COVID is here. Now that is why we cannot be in touch with people. So that's right. Very good, teacher. Now let's continue. Let's move on. And we are going to talk about simple present. Simple present is the tense that teachers usually teach, right? The first tense that teachers teach right now is simple present. I'm going to review this topic. And there is structure here. We have the form will be subject, the verb, and the predicate or object, right? Subject, verb, a predicate. Simple present, es el tiempo presente. And the meaning is to express a habit or a general truth. It's something that you always do, that you do or expressing, okay? There are some adverbs, for example, always, usually, often, sometimes, never. Es algo que haces diariamente, ¿verdad? Your daily basis. And when using in questions, we use do or does. I'm going to give you some examples here. Panama has a new education strategy due to the COVID-19. Panama has. Okay, now the next example, does Panama have a new education strategy? We use does in a question. Panama students receive classes using remote learning. Receive would be the present tense, receive. And the last one, do they receive classes using remote learning? Do, because we are using the pronoun they, that is plural. Do they receive classes using remote learning? Okay, there are some examples in simple present tense. Now let's do the last practice here. Practice, you need to write or complete the sentence using the simple present tense. Okay, number one, I, a Panamanian student, I study at. Okay, in this case would be, I am a Panamanian student. I study. Study, it will be simple present, yo estudio. I study at, in this case, name of the high school. You need to write the name of the high school. Okay, high school. And ahí donde te pregunta, que están en tu booklet, page 73, you need to write the name of your school. Tienes que escribir ahí el nombre de tu escuela. Number two, you have synchronous classes. Okay, you have synchronous classes. It's a question mark, so it will be do or does. That's right, it's do. Do you have? It's not has, have. We are using the pronoun you. Do you have synchronous classes? And also in the question will be also have. It's a question mark. Do you have asynchronous classes? And the number three, teacher Mario, we have the parentheses have, his classes on Mondays. And teacher Margarita, classes on Fridays. It's something that she always do. Ellos son lo que siempre lo hacen, ¿verdad? So, we are talking about teacher Mario. It's singular, so we use has. Teacher Mario has his classes on Mondays. And teacher Margarita also is singular. She is third person singular. It will be the pronoun she. She has classes on Fridays. Remember, yes, teacher Yosita?
We get a person here, Insta, Ana Cecilia, thumb up. Thank you, Ana Cecilia. And also she said, me gustó mucho la clase. Felicidades, teacher Evelyn.
Thank
Elena
you.
Elena Milagros and Maribeth, 14.
Hello, thank you. Okay, and and you can have access to your booklet on page 73. Remember that you have your booklet and you can practice this. This statement, this tense, that it will be simple present. And to finish, guys, you have an assignment here, right? Response to the following questions. It will be, review your notes about reading and review the vocabulary. Use the following diagram to show similarities and differences between Microsoft Teams and Zoom. In this case, there are students that are using Microsoft Teams, and there are other kind of students that use Zoom. So it's very important to read about what is Microsoft Teams about and also Zoom, and you need to make the differences and the similarities here. In this case, I will say that both of them can be used as a virtual classes here. You can be like face-to-face with your teacher and with your students as well. And Microsoft Teams also, you can upload information, can upload documents, assignments and homework, even though Zoom cannot. Zoom is just for conferencing, something like that you can just talk face to face in real time. Okay, and so this is the class for today. Hopefully we will have here for the next Friday, and teacher, psychologist Ira, thank you for being here, and teacher Yosira.
Hello, okay guys, so thank you for being here, okay, for participating in the class. A lot of people were here, actually 12th graders. Thank you very much. And we will see you next class.
That's okay. Right. Bye-bye. See Bye. You. Take care. Educate, educate.
A continuación, Noticiero Nacional Vespertino. Síguenos en Instagram, @NacionalFMPanamá. Somos más radio en las redes sociales.
Un día como hoy, 18 de septiembre de 1502, Cristóbal Colón llega a Honduras en su cuarto y último viaje. Un día como hoy en Nacional FM.
Nacional FM y Crisol FM te informan. Usa correctamente la mascarilla en el trabajo para evitar el contagio del COVID-19. Asegúrate que cubra tu nariz y boca. No te la pongas ni en el cuello ni en la cabeza. Si la tocas, lávate las manos. Si tu mascarilla es de tela, lávala con agua y jabón diariamente. Recuerda, si no es necesario salir, quédate en casa y mantente informado con Nacional y Crisol FM.
El nuevo Plan Educativo Solidario, nuestros estudiantes de escuelas públicas tendrán acceso gratuito a la Internet. Con el apoyo solidario de las 4 empresas telefónicas del país, desde el 14 de septiembre, la conexión a las clases virtuales en las plataformas Esther y Office 365 Teams será gratuita. A partir del 7 de septiembre, los acudientes deben registrar a los alumnos en la página web de Meduca o de Panamá Digital. Con el Plan Educativo Solidario, la educación, esa estrella que transforma vidas, llegará a más hogares panameños. Unidos lo hacemos. Atención panameños, a partir de este lunes 14, hombres y mujeres podrán salir cualquier día, pero se mantienen otras medidas sanitarias. En las provincias de Panamá y Panamá Oeste cambia el horario de toque de queda. En las provincias de Bocas del Toro, Colón y Chiriquí, el toque de queda se mantiene como está ahora. Cumple las normas sanitarias. No bajemos la guardia.
Una de las orquestas panameñas más querida por el público.
Obsesionado yo vivo por ti.
Mi Cultura en Casa 2.0 presenta a La Cachamba en concierto desde el Teatro Balboa. Hoy, desde las 8 de la noche, Todos Somos Panamá, Ser TV. Te invita Radio Reforma, Ondas del Canajagua, AM Original, Crisol FM, Nacional AM y FM.
Momento de estar en contacto con los hechos más importantes del día. Información completa y veraz. Noticiero Ser TV, emisión estelar por Nacional FM, de lunes a viernes a las 6 de la tarde. Nacional FM, somos más noticias.
El Gobierno Nacional, a través de Ser TV y el Ministerio de Cultura, a beneficio de Panamá Solidario, presentan Mi Cultura en Casa 2.0. Noche de Trovadores. Desde la Plaza Colonial de Parita, este sábado a las 8 de la noche, midiendo fuerza y potencia en sus voces, Toñito Vázquez y Hermenegildo Merejo Aparicio. Este sábado, a beneficio de Panamá Solidario, te invita Ser TV, el Gobierno Nacional, Ministerio de Cultura, Crisol FM, Radio Nacional AM y Nacional FM. Somos más espacio a nuestra diversidad cultural.